Where did I leave it? Where is it? Really? Oh, here. That was a very weird sound. I changed my mind. Of course I am. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today I'm giving you two looks and my final judgment of the Catrice Pro Vintage Soul Palette. This is the second look that I did in the video. I also did a first impression and timestamps will be down below. And the first impression will be linked down below and underneath the cards as well. At the end of the video, I give you my review. Just so you know, and some tips and tricks that I have found while working with this palette. Do check out my description box for all the information that you will find there. You will find timestamps there. You will find the makeup that I have on my face there. Some videos, some discount codes. Just go and check it out. Without further ado, let's just get into the looks, I think. Yeah, again, at the end of the video, I give you my thoughts. I don't know why I'm rambling, but apparently it's that kind of day today. Just grab a drink, grab a snack, put your feet up, because here comes look number one. Okay, let's do a look with the Vintage Soul from Catrice. I'm going to prime my eyes first with my favorite eye primer right now, and that is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Eye Primer. I'm just going to use a little. Catrice also has an eye base, and I actually think that they have a new eye base. I have used the one from Catrice for, I have used it for quite some time until it ran out and I found other ones that I like more. But if you want a very nice, very affordable eye base, it is definitely one to check out. And I do recommend using an eye base. It just makes such a difference. This is a pretty light color, but it makes the shadows pop a little bit more. And I just really, really tap it out, or tap it in, whatever you want. You can even take a beauty sponge and just go over it a little bit more, just to make sure that everything is distributed nicely and that you don't have any weird buildup anywhere. I think I have an idea. Let's start with this one called Sheer, because I kind of want a layer underneath the black. I'm going to use the black today. I want to kind of do a very smoky goodness. So that is probably for most people then more of an evening look. Not specifically for me though. So I'm just going to use that shade to set my eye base. And I usually don't use shades or anything to set my eye base. But if I am going to use black the way that I kind of want to use it, I do. And I just use an eyeshadow to do it. I could theoretically pull in another one, but I don't want to. I want to use the black and see what it does. So I'm going to go to black, which is called Noir. I can show you, but it is just a black. It's called Noir. I'm going to start in the outer corner. And I'm looking down, so that I don't start too high. I'm just going to work it in the crease. I'm going to do small, well, basically light layers, so that I can better control what happens. I'm slowly going to work it up by doing circular motions. I'm also going to work it underneath my eye. Wow. That's a very, very, very nice black. Well, it's gray now, but that doesn't matter. I'm going to go to a slightly smaller brush. Still the same shade. I'm going to deepen it up in the outer corner. The reason I'm going to a smaller brush now is because it is a little bit more dense. So it deposits a little bit more product. And I have already blended out the first layer, so I can basically just blend it in. And I really want that crease to be quite deep. Okay, I'm going to go back to the previous brush because it's slightly bigger. And then lightly blend all the layers together. And I'm checking regularly in a mirror that I have a little bit further away. Just to make sure that when I look forward, the shape that I have is nice. Is the way that I want it. Okay, now I'm going to go to an even smaller brush. Let's see if we can really build up the black. So now I'm just going to tap. Drag it forward slightly and fade it up a little bit, but just to help blend it well into itself. And it does so effortlessly. Very, very nice. And then it is just a matter of finessing it a little bit, just making sure that the layers are the way that I want them. And back to the first brush and the first shade. And just make sure that that top edge is blended out nicely. Same here underneath my eye. Okay, I'm grabbing my NYX Glitter Primer and a brush. Let me show you how much I use. It's not a lot. Here is the glitter primer on the brush and I hope you can see it. It's not a lot. And I'm going to whack that on my eyeball. And first I'm going to place it a little bit. And then I'm going to be precise. So I'm going to start in the beginning of my eye. I'm basically going to follow my eyeball. And I'm going to clean up my lid a little bit. That was what I want to say. I'm just swiping the color in. I know some people clean their lid with micellar water. I don't. I do it like this. You can also do this with your eyeshadow base if you want to put on a matte on top instead of a concealer. Okay, the next shade I'm going to go is a shade called Garden. Which is kind of a special shade. I'm just going to pat and swipe this on top. I'm just using the same brush. I can spray it a tiny bit. So I'm picking up some of the shades, which is pretty crumbly. That's why I'm going to spray just a little. To help it stick a little bit to the brush, as not to fall on my face. Very pretty. I'm going to finesse the line that I have with a tiny bit of black. Just going to go around the border and clean it up a little. Then I'm going to go to a slightly bigger brush, a little bit of the black. I'm going to go over, but a tiny bit higher. And I'm going to blend it up a bit. Okay, let's make sure that the black here on the outer part is nicely blended with that lighter shade. Very dark and dramatic, isn't it? Isn't it? As per usual. I have here an eye pencil. It's a gray, steel gray one from Catrice in the shade Absolute Graziness. Then I'm going to go to the shade called Moondust. I'm going to pick it up with the brush and I'm going to spray and it's going to go on top of my lower lash line. Oh, that's nice. I also want it a little bit in the outer corner. Just using this brush, it does not really matter. And maybe a little bit more in as well. Yeah, I think that's a bit better. It's very dark and dramatic, isn't it? I'm cleaning the brush. I'm going to go back to the shade garden, which is that special brush. Special shade. I'm going to spray it and I'm going to put it there in the inner corner. Then I'm grabbing my face highlighter. If I can get it open, yes. And it's going to go in the inner corner. Cool. That is basically one eye largely done. I'm going to finish off both eyes, including liner, lashes and all that goodness. Find a lippy, and then when you will next see me, it will be a very completed and cohesiveness, I hope. This is the completed look. Nice and dark and dramatic, just like me today. I think that the falsies really make the look. Not that I did not like the look before the falsies, but I just think that this adds more drama and really, really complements the look. Now, if you don't want to wear falsies, you obviously don't have to. If you are not comfortable with wearing falsies, then just don't. If you want to learn how to do falsies, I have a link in the description box to a tutorial on how I do my falsies. For lippy, I just went with, well, basically a glossy thingamajingy. It is also from Catrice, the Powerful 5-in-1 Liquid Lip Balm in the shade 70 Luminous Grapes. It's just very cutesy, I don't know, light, kind of like this. It goes with the theme of the palette, I believe. And I think that it complements this look very, very nicely. I just wanted to keep the lip a little bit softer. But this is it for the first look of the video. What I used on my face will be listed down in the description box. Let me know down below what you think of this look. Would you rock this? Let me know, and let's get ready for look number two. Look number two with the vintage soul. And let's see if I can kind of try to do a soft everyday look. I think I'm going to start with the shade called... Have I tried Cozy yet? And then with pink, so gray and pink. Yeah, that may be pretty. Let's go with the shade called Cozy. Which is a, I don't know if you can see, but it's a light gray on this one. I switched brushes. Still the same shade though, because I changed my mind. Of course I have. So I'm using this shade Cozy as a transition shade. And this has, it is a gray, but it is, when I look at it, it almost seems to have a little bit of a hint of a lavender in it as well. It's a very special shade, at least for me. Very unique. Then I'm going to go to a smaller brush and the shade called Haze, which is the darker one. And this almost seems to be a little bit more blue-gray almost. And that's going to go in the outer corner and the crease. Blend into each other very, very nicely. And I am creating, I don't know if you can see, I am creating more depth than a lot of color on my eye, which was the idea of today's look. Which is kind of weird for me, but still. I think I want the shade Haze underneath my eye too, but high maybe. So let me get a different brush for that. Something a little bit smaller. And if you want to, you can deepen it up with the black. And maybe I will grab a tiny, tiny bit, but I actually don't want to because I kind of want to keep it a little bit softer. So I do want to pull in the darker gray a little bit more here in the outer corner on the lid. And from here you have a lot of options, but the shade that I really want to use today is the shade called Cashmere. So I'm going to start with that, but first NYX Glitter Primer, if I can find it. Okay, then the shade called Cashmere that I just pointed out is going to go on my lid. Also stamping it a little bit on the gray on the outer corner. because I like it if there is a little bit of a shimmer going on there. Now let me get a little bit of that gray. Where's my brush? Haze, and make sure that it is nice and here. You know, I think that's almost it. Inner corner highlight. I also want something underneath there. I want to shade garden there maybe. Or shall I just stick to the plan? Let's see. Yeah, it's kind of nice. So I'm going to grab the shade called Garden, which is that greenier shade, on a small brush. And that is going to go there underneath, but I'm going to spray. So first picking up the eyeshadow and then spraying the brush. Really? Okay, let's do something that I usually don't do then. I think that is cutesy. What do I want for eye pencil? Do I want a green? No, I want a gray. Where's my gray? It could very well be the same pencil that I used in the previous look. I actually don't remember. Yeah, this is nice. This is from Catrice. You could also I could also have pulled in a nude, because I also have a nude. But yeah, I didn't. So yeah, there's that. This is in the shade Absolute Graziness. I think this is it for this eye. I'm going to do the same on that eye. Finish it off with liner and lashes, because yes, I'm going to wear lashes today. And the lippy, and then I will be back to show you the completed look and give you my final thoughts on the palette. So hold on tight, don't go anywhere. Everything is on. Here is the completed look. And for once, I was able to kinda keep it soft. Wow. I did not really use an eyeliner today. I just used the pencil and went old school and used that as eyeliner to keep it a little bit softer. Then I grabbed the black in the palette and kind of smudged it over that a little bit to get it a little bit, give it a little bit more depth. And the falsies I have on are also from Catrice. These are wispy styles, which are very, very natural. If I have a good mascara and I load up my own lashes, this is kind of what they look like. I just don't usually like that feeling, hence the fact that I put in falsies. These are in the style Insta Volume, in case you were wondering. And the lip is also from Catrice. It's their lip balm that I bought with this palette in the shade Luminous Grapes. What does it say? 5-in-1 liquid lip balm. I really, really like these. I also really like the color, specifically in combination with the shades that are in this palette. Let's go over the palette. I also said this in my first impression, that I am actually quite blown away by the quality of this palette. And you can go very, very light if you play in the beginning of the palette. You can go middle, you can go very deep and dark. The mattes perform beautifully. I think the black is one of the best blacks that I have in my collection. And even the light shades really showed up for me. And that was not really the case in the previous two palettes. So maybe it is the shades that they have, you know, the undertone. But overall, I think they perform gorgeously. I do prefer to use mine on a sticky base, but that is how I prefer to do my eyeshadow. You can use these on a set base, but they will be a little bit less intense, especially the lighter ones. The shimmers that are in here are very, very pretty. They are not overly foiled, but they are shiny enough that they still show. This is, you know, the lightest shimmer that I have. That we have in this palette, I put on my eyeballs today. I haven't used the shade Candlelight. This is a gorgeous highlighter, but this is not the shade that I put on my eyeballs often. I prefer it as a highlighter, but it is very, very pretty nonetheless. And the shade I have on my eyeballs now is Cashmere, and it's just a favorite shade of mine. I do prefer to use the shimmers on top of a glitter primer, but I always prefer that. So let me then kind of go to some of the tips that I have found working with this palette. Again, I think that especially the lighter shades pop more if you use them on a sticky base. I think that this is a palette that can cater to a lot of skin tones. I think it's very versatile, because unless you are extremely fair, this one will not show up on you. The rest will. If you are very deep, I think I think you could make shades work, but I am honestly not sure because it could very well be that they then turn ashy on you. I don't know. If you are watching this and you have a deeper complexion, please let me know down in the comment section how it fares for you, because I'm really, really curious. The other kind of thing that I want to give tips on are these two special shades. These have flakes in them. Now, I usually don't advocate going into a pressed eyeshadow with a wet brush. However, in the case of these two, I kind of do. The binder in here is a little bit looser because of the flakes. There is more air in them. And I just find that if I want to get the most amount of shadow on my brush, I need to go in with a wet brush. And I usually don't do that. I have done that with these two shades. I don't have hard pan. And that is... yeah, that is the reason I usually don't do it, but these two shades can handle it. So if you feel like you don't pick up enough on your brush with these two shades, try spraying them. Not make the brush soaking wet, but spray it with a little bit of water and then pick it up. The only kind of thing I want to bitch about palette wise is this green. It could have been more vibrant, because if I look here on the front of the palette, it's very nice and green. I would have loved this to be more vibrant, more vibrant green than it is now. However, now that I have kind of paired it the way that I have on my eyes, I do see why it is this specific shade of green, because it does complement especially the lighter tones very, very well. And can I just say this? I have been lusting after the Natasha Denona vintage mini palette. I don't need it, guys. I have it here. Because this is basically the vibe that that palette gave me, but I have it in the one from Catrice.
No,
maybe. I really like how this look turned out. I don't mind that it is a softer look. A lot of the time when I do a soft look, I'm like, it's not really flattering for me, or maybe it's just because I'm so used to very rich and deep eye looks that it is then, I don't know, lacking. But this gives me enough depth to... well, really, really like the way that it looks. And I don't feel like I need to darken it up even more, which is quite rare for me. So yeah, overall, I think the palette is an amazing quality. The shimmers are very, very pretty. They stay on for a very long time. You can use them dry. You can use them sprayed. But I prefer to use them on top of a glitter primer, because that is how I like my shimmers to be. And then the special shades, I told you, I think work best either with a finger or with a damp brush. Picking it up like that. The mattes layer beautifully. They blend out beautifully. And also the pigmentation, you know, especially for a drugstore brand. I am pretty impressed with Catrice in this round again. And I do think that all the pro palettes that they have, these are very, very good. It hasn't hit stores where I live yet. I do know that Boozy Shop sells it, but just here, at least here in the Netherlands, Boozy Shop sells it. Kruidvat has it online and maybe in the bigger stores, I don't know. And then Cosmetic for Less. So I will link Cosmetic for Less down below for the international people of you. And I don't know if they still have it in stock, but just sign up. You know, if you want to, at least sign up and they will kind of let you know when it is in stock again, because I think it is definitely worth grabbing. And I cannot wait to see what other palettes they are coming out in this format next. I do want to get a few of their small 5-pan palettes, because I'm really curious. I was hoping that they would come to store here, but they haven't as of yet. So I just think that I know that Boozy Shop has them, so I will just order them online because I need a new shade of foundation and concealer anyway. I will also leave the other two videos that I did with the other palettes down in the description box, and the first impression as well. Go check out my description box, because my makeup will be there as well. There also will be timestamps and discount codes and more information and all that. And then this is going to be it for today's video. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.